This is history. Don't you know history, Sudhanshu Trivedi?
Arnav, you have said very well. The person should go in the history. What was there in the Act of Parliament in 1951 after...
What was there in 1877?
Prime Minister? And in 1965 post-independence, M.C. Chagla, who was the education minister, on the floor of the parliament has said, AMU is neither established nor monitored by Muslim community, so this is not a minority institution, it is a central government institution.
A Muslim reformer called Syed Ahmad Khan says it is important for Muslims to gain education and become involved in public life and services. Muslims should learn the English language. And therefore, he started the foundation of a Muslim university by starting schools in Moradabad and Ghazipur in 1858 and 1863. You are denying history. You are denying history.
I am not
Sudhanshu,
denying history.
You know you are denying.
This was
so don't argue technically with me. Argue
then what was the
on the basis
AMU
of
Act
reason.
Of 1920? And by that act.
Yeah, what Sunye, happened?
Arya Samaj ke Sanstapak. Sunye, baat sun lije. Now accept. He has established DAV colleges by Arya Samaj, Dayanand Anglo-Vedic College. What you will call? This is the Vedic college only specific, the only the person who believes
Hindu
in the Vedic
you want to do a takeover.
Only get. What do you mean?
No, I'll get the other
government
side.
Government cannot be seen as patronizing a religion.
Mustafa,
if you want a minority status, no problem. Darul Uloom Deoband is a minority institution. Nadwatul Ulema Lucknow is a minority institution.
I'll open the debate.
To put such a esteemed organization like AMU in the minority status and deprive the SC and ST their due?
You,
and if you give a 50% reservation to the Muslims, as the previous government...
So you want to remove the Muslim reservations in the university? That's the point.
I want a categorical answer. Yes or no? And second thing, by this logic, Arnav, one day the Khalsa College 50% reservation, then St. Stephen will say 50% for Christians, then a Jain institution will say 50% for Jains, and a Buddhist institution will say 50% for Buddhists, and a Parsi will say 50% for Parsis, a Baha'i will say... What do you want to make a Republic of India?
Have you finished? Now understand.
I want a categorical answer.
Okay, I'll get the other side. Professor Rizwan Kesar, Madhukar Jaitley and S. Mustafa Zaidi may want to respond if they will. By the way, gentlemen, it's an open debate. By the way, before they respond, let me tell you one thing, Sudhanshu Trivedi. Your contention is that these institutions were established by an act of parliament. You are right. But the parliament's involvement came in much later after these institutions had already been set up with the intention of promoting education among the Muslim community. In 1920, an act of parliament is a follow-up.
GHU?
The 1920 act of parliament is a follow-up.
What about Banaras Hindu University? This was also established by a particular motive of Madan Mohan Malvi, but subsequently after independence, it became a central university.
So you want to take over all the Muslim universities?
And it has been subsequently established
okay, I'll open the debate.
Nehru government, Indira
okay,
government.
Rizwan, Rizwan Kesar may want to respond to you. Please, 1 second. Rizwan Kesar is responding to you now, please. Rizwan Kesar, first Rizwan.
I shall speak for the university where I work, Jamia Millia Islam.
Right.
Everybody must know that it was not established by any act of parliament or state legislature or whatever. It was established by a group of nationalist Muslims in the wake of the call of Mahatma Gandhi to fight against the British. That's number one. 1963, when it was declared to be the deemed university, I mean, like, it was not fully funded university. Things continued on. In 1988, it was given the status of a central university. Now, why Jamia became a minority? It was no gift from any government. It is by no executive order that it became a minority. It was given by National Commission for Minority Educational Institutions. Number two, the people who challenge its minority tag, they challenge it in the Honorable Delhi High Court. And the matter is pending there. And Honorable High Court, on the plea of lot many people that they should be stayed, it declined to stay. And it said that it shall continue enjoying all the privileges which are meant for a minority institution, and that is how Jamia has been there since 2011 till now. If today, because of the change of the regime, there is a change of stance in the ministry, whether of law or human resource development.
No, that's not what they're saying. Professor Kaiser, that's not what they're saying.